Welcome back to WebDriver training. So in today's class we'll be seeing about web tables. So I think you all are familiar with web tables, so we frequently see in our websites. So we'll see today how we'll automate the tables which are present in websites, nothing but web tables. Okay, so if it is a web table, it will have some number of rows and number of columns. So if you want to extract a particular cell text from complete web table, so how do you do that? And how you will take the row count? So sometimes you have a little automation experience in other tool, or some, not Selenium, some other tools like. So you'll be knowing how important to know the row count and column count to extract a particular cell text. Okay, so we'll be seeing from basics. So how to start with a table automating using WebDriver, and how to identify the row count, how many rows are present in the table and how many columns are present in the table, and how to extract the third row, second column, like some jth column, how to extract the text from particular cell. Okay, so for that I'm using this website, espncricketinfo.com. So look here, and this is a table, one of the table, web table. See, it is like these all are rows and these are columns. And firstly we'll start with HTML table basics. Okay, so I'll do one thing, take notepad here. How to know whether the particular element is in table or not? This is our first challenge. In WebDriver, we need to identify. So see, now I'm telling by saying that this is a table. So how we will come to a conclusion by seeing a website whether it is in table or not? If the particular web table is in table format, then that particular table will have tr and td tags. Okay, let me write. It will have tr and td tags. I'll change the font of this. Give me 1 second. Right. Okay. Tr tag will be written for creating rows. Okay. Td tag is written for writing a data in particular row. Okay. If something is in table, generally we see tr and td tags. This is how HTML people write the table in the website. Okay, this is how web tables are built with HTML. Okay, the rows are given in tr format and the data in particular row is given in td format. So if you find these tags in your application, then and no doubt that particular item what you are searching is in web table. Okay, you can come to conclusion like this. Now what I'll do is I'll spy somewhere on Watson here, and I'll open the firebug, and you can see here td tag. Look here, the things are written in some tr and td, some stuff you are seeing here. That means these all particular stuff is written in table. Okay, this is the way how you can come to conclusion. Look here, this is the data, and if you see this, tr and td tags are there. So you are going to automate a table thing. By seeing this, you can come to conclusion. Okay, this is how the basic HTML, how you will identify the table, whether it is in table or not. Okay, now first I'll open, we'll try to hit this URL in Eclipse. Okay, now I'll go back and I'll show some logic. Try to follow me here. Okay, I spy somewhere here on Harbhajan somewhere. Okay, then open the stuff. And see, now by now you should be able to identify the See, I didn't debug the fire bug. Okay, from last classes, what you have learned. So I have clearly told how to find traverse to child element from the parent tag. Okay, we have discussed a lot of things. So by seeing that, you will be now you should be able to clearly debug this stuff. For example, now I just spied here on TD class. Here it is. So identify where it is. This is in this tag. Okay, data. And all this data are in this row. Okay, I'm telling you again, once again, in each, for each tr row there will be multiple td tags. That means, and here if you see, and this is the first row here, Watson Harbhajan. Okay, for this whole row developer will write tr tag, and in each row this is one column. This is one column, 0 is one column, 9 is one column, 7 is one column. For all these columns, he will use TD tag for each column. For 0, he will use 1 TD column, for 9, 1 TD, and for 7, 1 TD, till the end. And he will close TR tag at the end. And again, he will freshly open other TR tag for other row. Again, in that tag, he will use all TD tags. TD tags are nothing but number of columns. TR tags are nothing but number of rows. And this is the easiest way to you to remember, okay, or to decode. TR tag is nothing but row. We are in that row. TD under TR in the sense columns in that row. Okay. So for all TRs we'll have TDs, right? So TDs are nothing but columns. Tags how in such a way they'll write. So now I'll just go back, and this is a TD tag. These all are columns. Look here, 0, 9, 7, 0, all these are columns of first TR tag. And this is the TR tag. In this row, these many columns are written. Okay? Now, basically what I'll do is, all these rows and columns are started from, try to find this table. Once close this, everything is getting closed. That means all the rows and columns are written in this table. If you see the table tag, that means what developer is going to tell here, I have written everything in this table. See, when I am closing this, everything, all the rows and columns will be get closed. That means all the stuff are present in this table tag. Look here, I am highlighting table ID is equal to innings bat 1, all the stuff. So this is the table. Here nothing but, and this is one. For this table, he created ID. Developer has given table ID. In that, a lot of rows are there, and for each row, different columns are there. Look here, these all are the rows here. Okay, each row nothing but TR. That's what I have clearly mentioned you. Developer, for each row, he will use one TR tag. And in each row, there will be a lot of columns, right? For each column, he will use TD tag. For example, and this is our table, nothing but the first table which I highlighted before. Let me highlight again. And this is our table. And if you come down, you'll just first your step is try to identify the table ID. Once you identify that, you just when you open it, there will be a lot of tiers. That means these many rows are there. If you open the first row, you can see TDs. These are the columns present in this TR row. In this innings head row, these are the columns. If you close, that's if you open the second row, and these are the columns present in the second row, which have written with TD tag. Okay, all these rows and columns are present in this table ID tag. That means everything lies in this table. So what I'm doing is now, so we need to do some smart testing here. We'll go with an, what is an ID here? By dot ID innings bat 1. Okay, this is nothing but table ID. First I'll grab it so that all the columns, row stuff, everything will become into this particular, we'll be getting into our grip. Once we grab this, everything is present inside it. Okay, so element, I'll give some table name. Okay, I'll give just I created object as table. Okay, import some stuff which is required, and right now table has everything now, because total stuff which is present inside this, I have taken this location. Okay, I have by dot id innings bat one I have taken, so everything lies here in this table now. Now if I want to find the number of rows present in this table, now I need to know finding the rows in table. Now I am interested only in this table. Okay, so if you remember in previous class we have discussed about a subset stuff. So in the from the whole page I will grab one particular subset, and if I want to find any information in that subset, I will use this, I will go on with subset tag. Do you remember I have used some Amway site? So if you are clear with that, which I have took some different examples to explain that, if you are clear with that, it will be very easy to you. If not, please watch a previous module. So how I am taking subset, all this you will understand. Now I am interested to find the rows in this table. Okay, total this subset powers will are there in this table. Okay, driver has total complete web page is in driver object hand, this driver. Now what I have done, I have taken by id innings bat one, so first innings, so this total subset I grabbed into table object. Okay, by writing this step. Now if I need to find the rows in this table, I'll give like this. So do you remember what I have told? If you want to know the number of rows, nothing but tag name, number of tr tag names present in web page. Okay, I'll write like this, table dot find elements. Look here, the return type should be list. You see clear list, it's clearly written that list should be the return type. Tag name, I am finding, go and find the tag names which have tr in this table, so that the count which I get is nothing but the number of rows present in that table. Getting? I'll give us number of rows. Okay, if I give the return type is the list, because I shown you before. So if the because I am going to get more than one row, so if you get only one, you can go directly with web element. But I have the list of more than one. If I have more than one web element, I am telling I need the list of web elements. Okay. So if you observe here, so that's what I told. If you are confused why I am not using driver dot find element, because if I use driver dot go and find elements by tag name tr, driver will have entire access page. If I say driver dot find elements with tag name tr, it will check entire page and it will give the list of all the rows present in a page. That's what I am not interested in that particular scenario. I just need only the rows present in this table. That's the reason the entire table ID I have taken into the table object, and I'm just telling table dot find elements. That means just go and find elements with tag name tr in table object only. That means only in this particular stuff. Okay. Now let's print out. Let's see what's the count. Number of rows are okay. I'll concatenate, and I think it's pretty much to run our first program. Yep, okay. We'll run and see. So So I'm just the logic just I have used to find the rows is tag names with tr. Number of trs is equal to number of rows. Yeah. We also see how to find the columns with the td tag. Firefox launched. Site got open. We'll go back to console. It's still loading. Number of rows. Just mistake I have done. I need to know the count. Okay, to know the count, we need to give dot size. Okay, I just mentioned here. So dot size gives the number of count, right? And now it will show. This is how in practice you will learn a lot and more. It happens, silly mistakes. Yeah, page is loaded. It's still loading. Let's go back to our Eclipse. We can see the count here. Yes, number of rows are 17. Look here.